people. Yes, I'm going to do this one as a new thunder. I just want you to see how they're actually changing the pictures of Cahokia. I mean, Cahokia, you know, the big mound. Beautiful. Wonderful. The last time I came here, this picture wasn't here. It was more ethnic looking. This one looks more like, I have no idea what this beakneck thing is, but you can get a little closer so you can actually see it. It's kind of ridiculous to say that that's a monk of Cahokia. Talking about people getting their identity stolen, it's insane. I just wanted to take a little walk with you up the Cahokia Mound. Let's stop over here and see how things are changing. Here we go, the monks. Let's see what do the monks of Cahokia look like today. Very different from the time that I was here last time. I want you guys to see that. Right? Some history there. And then, who are those guys? I don't know, but they sure don't look like the real people. But, you know, got things going on. Just want you to take a good look as to what's going on now. That's the reason why you have to get out here and really begin to start taking a look at what's happening before they do change everything, because of all these different new resets that are going on. It's quite crazy. So the mound itself, you know, still there. You know, the original story about these mounds and stuff like that, when you asked the Native Americans, is that they don't know who built these things, and yet they gave them control over it. They said that when they got here, the mounds are already here, and you know, when you're dealing with Cahokia, you know, a little overcast day today, but they try to say Cahokia was just a small little area in the St. Louis area. That's where it is, Illinois. But you can see that mound over there. That's huge. You can see that. It doesn't really resonate too big, but I'll get a little bit one. Hard to really give you an actual definition of this place, because unless you're here by yourself, you can only imagine how large these things really are and how monumentous, you know. And not too far from here, what they did, they built a garbage mound, which is crazy. But you can see how small the people are up there. They look like little ants. That's how big it is. So are you ready to climb the steps of Cahokia? Beautiful mound place. And again, like I said, they're trying to say to you that this place was only as big as the area that they have mapped out here. Another little thing here, you can stop it and take a little take a look at it. They're trying to say that, you know, and these aren't the original steps. But they're gonna climb the steps of Cahokia here. Like I was trying to tell you, they're trying to say that this whole entire place was just as big as just the area that they have these few mounds in. But this area is once as big as the whole entire St. Louis area itself, which I also believe through study included the whole entire area of St. Louis City itself. So when you're looking at this, you gotta understand that the Aboriginal Indigenous Indians, American Indians, are actually the ones who really made this. All right, we're up in the first level now. Crazy, but you can see almost, again, how magnificent this place is. Hard to really detail it out when you're doing things. All right, so the other thing I wanted to show you is another little thing to get down here for some history. Right, and again, this really doesn't tell the whole entire history, but let's look at the dates. Right, call them ceremonial mounds, but I want you to look how large the promenade is pool goes up to the last level up there. It's really, really just amazing. Really just amazing. And when you think of all the different American Indian groups that are popping up all over the place, you understand that this is what they kind of destroyed. Ready to take the last little lick, climbing the steps of Cahokia. All right, here we go. Starting the steps, climbing the last steps of Cahokia. Again, remember, this is not the original stair steps. He put this in. So you can imagine how many great things happened during the time of all this building. And how many great things and how many people actually really served during the thousands and thousands and maybe even tens of thousands of years that this has been in existence. Really, really amazing. Again, you take a look at that promenade. Just look at how this mountain is built. Just amazing. Again, just a little bit. People are starting to look like ants still. Just amazing. You see all the way back there, all the different mounds. And here we go. Climbing the last bit of steps of Cahokia. Come on, everybody, let's go. Lots of people coming. I don't want to be on camera. But, yeah. Climbing the steps. On the other side here. I have to attach my hat better. How you doing there? Yeah, when you imagine, you know, here we go. Up to the top of Cahokia. And now I'm at the base here. And crazy. You can see the same little arch in the background. But again, from my studies, St. Louis was a Aboriginal indigenous area of great commerce, which included Cahokia. And they're trying to say that this is this little bit was all of Cahokia, which we know now is not the case. Is not the case at all. So they destroyed hundreds of thousands of mounds, in fact, millions of mounds all around the Americas, destroyed them, flattened them out, and used it for farmland. So just about every farmland you go by probably had amazing mounds that were on there. And in the area that you're living in now, you can also even be living in mounds as well. I mean, the mounds in Memphis is just magnificent. Clad my ceremony right off the Mississippi. And you can see my truck down there. It's pretty big. Pretty impressive. I like that. But anyway. Yeah. So, you know, the mounds of the three sisters in Georgia. You know, the capital of Coosa, nation state. Beautiful. There's beautiful mounds over there in Virginia, over there. They have a lot of great Aboriginal Indians. They're getting their land back. Lots of stuff. Just beautiful, but look how big the promenade is. Just huge. And again, you can see the Arch of St. Louis, which is not too far away. Just wanted to let you know, okay? People first come up here, they take a look at this stuff and say, okay, this is how big it was. But here they're giving you a hint here on how large Cahokia really is. And it goes all the way down to that arch, right? How large this arch is. And you can see the arch, again, not too far from here, right? St. Louis, again, St. Louis was just a big giant city that was connected to the grounds of Cahokia, where over here in this area was one of the largest Aboriginal indigenous American Indian trading ports of the Americas. again, you have the Mississippi River that runs through here, and you know, again, a lot of the Aboriginal Indians and their the places where they lived did not have the roads we have today, but they had the canal systems, which they buried over in the Continental War and in the Civil War, buried a lot of those things. So it's very important for us to understand that, you know, the landscape that we see now has been remarkable change of the invaders that came. And it's, you know, quite depressing, really, when you think about it. But I'm going to show you a few more of these things. But this is Cahokia. We are on a very sacred mound. You know, look it up. You know, you're going to see, you know, here goes a temple that was on this spot here. Right? Temples and stuff. Please don't climb on the mounds, right? Climb on the mounds, but I just want to be able to give you a look at what all these things are. Again, when people first come here, you know, they get all the little basics of what they tell you of the narrative of what went on here. But the real story is that the Kunk, the people who came over here and murdered the people that lived here, right, disassumed possession. You see the stockade and stuff like that. I don't believe there's any stockades at all, because our people really didn't build the wood. That's the reason why there were so many beautiful, beautiful areas of woodlands. We didn't build with wood, we built with stone. We had very fine, beautiful concrete that today, to this day, they cannot replicate. You know, that's where you got that natural concrete stuff, that natural concrete. They were actually mining that natural concrete that came from Aboriginal American Indian pyramids and structures and castles that were buried underneath a great calamity. Some people call that the mud flood. Okay, I just wanna, anybody's looking, give anything else. You know, they talk about the excavations, and they remember a lot of these places, a lot of the mounds that you see, a lot of people, they lived on top of the mounds, right? Some of the smaller mounds, there were people's neighborhoods, there were people's houses. They built mounds on them. Well, the mounds that they built living quarters on them. They built the living quarters. Very interesting, very beautiful, when you begin to start understanding what's really going on. There's the Great Mississippi over there. Get a little bit of closer to that. Oh, that's the Great Mississippi. I believe they use that as a great transportation hub. Right? Great transportation hub. And then I got one more little thing to show you over here. The Cahokia was a lot larger than what they say it is. And as you can see, the grounds that they have here now, I mean, there's a lot of, there's a trading post. People from all around the Americas came here and traded a lot of stuff. So at any given point, this area here can grow anywhere from 500,000 to a million people, if not more, because there are over 300 million people in the Americas before they started destroying them all. Over hundreds of millions, hundreds of millions. Well, this is Cahokia. Here it is. It is beautiful. And again, you can see the arches of St. Louis, not too far away, which was the parent city for this area. That's about it. Get ready to ascend the mountain, or the descend. We ascended already. We're going to descend the mound, the pyramid mounds. But as you can see on the back, there's a lot of pyramid mounds out there, and I believe that there was a hell of a lot more before they came and destroyed them all. And so I'm just going to show you the steps. I'm going to concentrate on walking down so I don't embarrass myself in this video. Alito, Asio, Mahalo, my good friends. Love you all.